Hello everyone. So we have covered TM mode also in rectangular waveguides. So this video is about TE mode in rectangular waveguides as you are watching on your screen. So this is the basic equation as we know we have used in TM mode. So here also we are getting HZ value. So basically what is the difference in TE mode is that here EZ equals to zero. Here TE mode, here EZ equals to zero. Basically electric field in longitudinal field is zero. So you have to solve for HZ. Okay, you have to solve for HZ. If we solve for HZ, we get similar solutions using the separation value, separation variables as we have used in TM mode. Okay, so let's see here. We know, but we don't have any boundary condition in HZ. Also remember that. So after solving for this, we are getting EX value and EY value. So remember, we don't have any boundary condition in terms for EX and EY. So we have to convert this is HZ into or in terms of EX and EY. Again, we are using the general solutions for TE mode. Okay. So what we're going to do is we need to apply derivation. We will apply a derivation for this HZ. We will do the derivative. Okay, then we will get components EX and EY. After that derivation, we will apply boundary condition. Also remember, we are not applying boundary condition directly for HZ. We are applying in terms of EX and EY. So one more thing, in that we can write any transfer component in terms of longitudinal component. Means HZ is a longitudinal component. We can write EX and EY in terms of HZ. For that we have to take derivative. Means what? Why we have to take derivative? We need to write in terms of HZ in terms of EX and EY. Okay, this is the main part. So now also remember, we took derivative in terms of X here and in terms of Y here. Okay, HZ with respect to X and with respect to Y. After derivative, what we saw, if we apply EX equals to zero and Y equals to zero, our component D becomes zero here. See, here D becomes zero. So on a similar pattern, if EY equals to zero at X equals to zero, B equals to zero. Now in HZ component, are in C in the main equation HZ here. Here B will become zero, also C will become zero. And what we will remain with H as a function of X, Y, Z. Here we are getting the final equation as AMN cos m pi x by a into cos n pi y by b e raised power minus jota beta z. It is a propagational, it shows the direction of propagation of the ray. So now we get by using this equation we can calculate ex, ey, hz and hy. So this is it you have to do for this equation. Now let's see the cutoff frequency. The cutoff frequency will be same as we have earlier seen in the case of TM mode. It will be same. So what is the difference here? See, EX equation is like that when we use separate method to write it, and EY equation will become this. Now HZ equation will become this. Now what happened? What we are going to do is we will apply m equals to 0 and n equals to 0 modes for here. So what we will get, ex equals to 0, ey equals to 0, also hy equals to 0 and hy equals to 0, hx, all the component will become 0, but this is not possible together that all the components will become 0. So we'll apply another case where m will be 1 and n will be 0. We will apply these types of case further. So what we get, ex equals to 0, but ey is not equal to 0. Also ey equals to hy equals to 0 and hx is not equal to 0. We are applying here. We are applying in these equations. So we are getting the value of ex, ey. On a similar pattern, we can hx and hy. Similarly, as if we get ex, ey, we have the value of hx and hy. So what happened? We get, if m equals to 1 and n equals to 0, we get values ey, hx and hz. Therefore, if we put m equals to 0 and n equals to 1, we get values, we will find the values of ex, hy and hz. See, these modes are present, or we can say these transverse modes are present only if we keep the values of m and n like this. So cutoff frequency for mode TE10 means here a value of m equals to 1 and n equals to 0 is always frequency of mode 10 is always less than frequency of 01 mode. Here it is cutoff frequency. Also remember TE10 means here m equals to 1, n equals to 0. Okay. So here m equals to 0, n equals to 1. This means the mode format. This cutoff frequency is always less than this mode cutoff frequency, or we can say it may be any other mode, any other pattern also. M values may be changed in this case. But this frequency should always less than these frequency. Therefore, we can say that FC10 is a cutoff frequency of dominant mode, and here TE10 is called the dominant mode. Nothing we have did, we just observed the TE equation and how we just did the derivative part. We did the derivative part here with respect to hz with respect to x and hz with respect to y. After that, we applied the boundary condition and we got this equation, and from this we can find these component. Now for the cutoff frequency, it will be same as in TM mode, and here we have see what ex, ey, hz mode. Similarly, we can get equation for hx and hy. So if we apply m and n equals to 0, what happened? And when we change the value, what happened? And for that, we observe when the FC10 cutoff frequency at mode 10 is always less than cutoff frequency at 01 mode or any other mode. So therefore, it is called as cutoff frequency of dominant mode, and this TE10 is called dominant mode. So I hope you have understood this lecture. Thank you for watching this video.